So Steve, we're here to celebrate UAE Rugby. You're a UAE resident yourself. How are you finding the night like tonight?
It's great. You know, last year was the first one, and I think there's a bit nerves around, you know, how it's going to go and things like that. So tonight was a bit more relaxed, and you know, that's what rugby's all about. You know, bringing everyone in, celebrating what a great season it's been, and you know, seeing people from the minis up to like the seniors, you know, winning awards. And for me, you know, you've got people like Neil Palmer, you know, they've brought the award in now for him, which is fantastic. And that just shows what a real true spirit of rugby there is in the UAE.
How do you see the health of UAE rugby as we speak today?
Yeah, I think it's growing rapidly, you know, and you know, with young Emiratis, they're starting to get more and more, you know, about 3,500 now they're looking at, and they're looking to really, you know, double that in the next few years. But also you've got to look at the expat rugby, you know, the schools rugby, the clubs rugby, and that's a really strong environment to be in, and that's a great way of getting the Emiratis involved. Is, you know, with the expats, you know, week in, week out, like they do, training, playing, and just encouraging the Emiratis to come through. And you know, I keep saying it, that's the rugby family, and that's the great thing about it. You know, it's really starting to take off here now, and you know, with the Emiratis here now, with the rugby board and things like that, they're actually starting to see what it's like, and they're actually talking about this family in rugby now, and that's a good thing. And they're learning, you know, they're travelling around the world with the IRB and things like that, and that's really starting to take part of it and buy into it. And for me, it's a great place to be at the moment.
How do you see nights like tonight helping with the rugby family in the UAE?
I think it's great. You know, at the end of the year, you've got to turn around. There's always winners and losers, you know, sport at the end of the day. And, you know, you have to stand up there and say, you know, some players have been outstanding. They've got to be rewarded for that. And that's a great thing about that, you know. And, you know, playing professional sport like I did in the past, like I said a minute ago, there are winners, there are losers. It's one of those things. But then also, you know, you get Clubman of the Year, you know, the best club of the year, things like that. And for me, that's what rugby's about as well, you know, taking part. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's about getting the numbers into the game. And I think all the clubs have been, you know, successful this year, and as long as the clubs are growing and getting bigger and bigger, you know, for us, you know, looking down at, you know, on the UAE, you know, advisory committee, that's what we want. We want to be able to see the growth in rugby in Emiratis plus with the expats.
What has been the message from the UAE advisory committee in the last 12 months compared to last one? What progress have you guys made? What areas need to be improved?
When you look at that, you know, the one thing is actually building a solid foundation for rugby to be here. It's not about Emiratis, it's not about expats, it's about rugby. So that's what we're trying to do, and also marrying the cultures together. And for that, that's been quite easy lately. And for me, you know, it's just getting the numbers up to it, and also just, you know, hopefully I'll be helping out a bit more with the national team and doing a bit of coaching there. And for me, you know, getting a successful UAE national team, but then also seeing competitive, you know, with Saracens they were playing this year, how that they played, Quins, you know, Alain, you know, how well they were doing. And for me, it's making sure, you know, and watching it, and hopefully trying to grow the rugby here so the rugby gets more and more competitive every year. And you know, I think by the sounds of it, and I went to a few games this year, the rugby was a higher quality than last year, and that's all you can ask for, you know. And people enjoy it, that's the main thing. You know, it's not a professional game out here, you know, people give it up, you know, in their spare time and things like that. And for me, it's enjoyment, but then also going out there giving your best, and hopefully someone wins the league and they win it well.
Are you talking about yourself there, getting involved with the national team? What will that mean? How do you see that working?
Just as an advisor. You know, Apollo's got involved now in there, which is a great asset for the UAE rugby. You know, it's a real good thing. You know, I've got a young family at the moment, so I can't give too much time, but you know, I can go up there at certain training sessions and advise, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm not sure they're ready for it yet, but it'll be quite funny because, I can be a bit of a pain in the backside if I'm honest. But so I'm looking forward to it actually. You know, I fell out of love with rugby after I finished in 2011, and I've just started to watch it again. You know, watch all the Six Nations and starting to watch some of the Super Rugby and things like that. So for me, I'm starting to get back into it now, and you know, I think it's the right time for me to, able, you know, give something back to rugby because, you know, it gave me such a great life.